vision-enabled fruit sorting system, using machine vision and machine learning technologies for academic research. Part 1, image classification and model creation. The development platform includes TensorFlow as machine learning platform, Python as scripting language, PyCharm as Python development IDE, OpenCV for image processing and Modbus Protocol for communication between PC and PLC. The hardware for the project includes a powerful Intel processor-based PC, NVIDIA graphics, machine vision camera, proximity sensor, Phoenix Contact PLC and a conveyor. As we have the hardware and software platforms set ready now, the next step is image classification and model creation. We have taken an apple for creating the first dataset. As you can see, we are taking images from different angles and covering all parts of the object. Capture as many random images of the object as possible, so that we can generate a more realistic model for high accuracy and better prediction. All the images captured are stored in the dataset folder with relevant label name or class name. Image classification is an important step, which we will have to do it carefully. We have taken almost 1,000 images of the red apple and now repeating the process with a green apple. Dataset creation for apple, and we'll start the process for another fruit called rambutan. Thank you. except for rambutan. per the epoch parameter we set in the script file. Finally, model evaluation is done, and the model creation process is completed successfully. Now, we will switch into the terminal window. Here, we run the command to get the URL for graphical view of model creation. Top graph indicates the accuracy details, and bottom graph indicates the loss details. Smoothing slider can be adjusted to view the graph more precisely. The blue graph indicates the accuracy on top graph and loss details on bottom graph. We can see the accuracy achieved after each training run on top graph, and similarly reduction of loss after each training run on bottom graph. The orange graph indicates the validation data after each run. This information is useful to decide the model creation parameters, like epoch value, to achieve high accuracy and minimum loss. Now, let us have a look into the confusion matrix, a table that is used to define the performance of a classification algorithm. A confusion matrix visualizes and summarizes the performance of a classification algorithm. In our case, we can see that the prediction is 100% accurate. A confusion matrix is useful in the supervised learning category of machine learning to fine-tune the algorithm for high accuracy and performance. Part 2. Prediction and output control. Now, we are running the prediction script, also switching on the conveyor and placing the fruits for prediction. Now, you can see that, based on the prediction, LED light is glowing on separate PLC channel for both apple and rambutan. See that the fruits we used for image classification and model creation are kept aside, and we have taken a new set of fruits for prediction and output control. Please watch the prediction values for both apple and rambutan when it is passed in front of the camera. We can see accurate prediction value of 1 for both fruits. Once again, see the prediction and output control indication on the PLC. Now, with this, we will conclude.